Ford lady, I am very cranky, and the last thing I want to do is help you with your idiotic cooking show. Zootalo.
Now your mama's official little helper. Yes, you are. So, let us decorate our pastry with some chocolate icing. You like chocolate, don't you? Yes, you do.
If you do not stop patronizing me, I will kill you, then sleep like a baby.
Sorry, puppy, I think that's dry clean only. I'll get you a little club soda later. Now, gently blend the chocolate into the icing like so, and voila! You have a dessert fit for an emperor. Now, the fun part. We get to name this delicious new pastry. Any ideas?
That's the guillotine.
Oh, well, not exactly what I had in mind. Wait, I know. Let's call this the Napoleon.
I like that. That's very nice. The Napoleon. A delicious puff pastry named after me. Bon, that is much better, oui.
Not only am I the gorging gourmet, I'm the fast-thinking gourmet.
It's Loud Kiddington and his dog, Fetch!
Howdy, Hannibal!
Your lease on the elephants is up, and you've exceeded your mileage.
That'll be 10,000 denarii!
Payment due.
Eat up, Booby! There's more where those came from!
And so, on a belly full of yummy pastries, Napoleon and his army went on to lose the Battle of Waterloo.
You can't win them all!
So long! The beats!
Talk too loud, talk too loud, talk too loud!
Bon appetit!
We've been sailing on the pyramid for days and days on end. We've been logging big blocks of stone. We help our blisters mend. My achy head's about to fall off. My nerves are pretty shot. It's a job that's really lousy because it's so darn hot.
5 score years ago, a great American in whose symbolic shadow we
August 28, 1963. The event, a march on Washington.
You say these interpreters never make a mistake.
I never chew my cabbage twice, honey. Pay attention now. President Kennedy is going to address the General Assembly.
My era friends, it is time for candor. It is time for truth.
I bet you could get a lot of dates if you were president.
A great civil rights leader who helped organize this gathering is giving what is considered to be one of the greatest speeches in all history.
So even though we face the difficulties of today and tomorrow, I still have a dream.
It's Loud Kiddington and his dog, Fetch.
If you want to strike it rich by mining gold,
never mind the howling winds are freezing cold.
Hook the dog up and you'll mush.
Come and join the clinic rush.
Talk too loud, talk too loud, talk too loud.
Howdy, prospectors and miners. Loud Kiddington here. And if I can't make you a deal, my dog, Fetch, here will eat a caribou chip. Yes, sir. You can mine for gold and Canada's Yukon Territory.
It is a dream deeply rooted in the American dream. I have a dream that one day this nation will rise up, live out the true meaning of its creed.
The history of Antarctica, complete and unabridged.
After all, isn't that the purpose of having a United Nations? With this in mind, I want to tell you exactly what I think of each and every one of you.
You're gross and disgusting.
Gross?